our discussion and what the culmination of an effort that began several years ago by individuals who are passionate about fish and their habitat. Among those individuals was a man who many of us knew as a friend and colleague, Dr. Alan Bates. Doc Bates was also my state senator, and he was an avid outdoorsman and fly fisherman. In that capacity, he really understood the web of life found in our life rivers and the fragility of that ecosystem. He would be glad to know we are having this conversation today. In brief, Senate Bill 3 establishes long-term regulatory reform of suction-dredge mining to protect sensitive, somatic, and mangrove habitats. Suction-dredge mining is a form of recreational gold mining that vacuums up riverbeds using a motorized floating dredge. This type of mining can trap and kill young fish and fish eggs, including threatened salmon and lamprey. Motorized dredges release plumes of sediment that can smother gravel beds in the river bottoms that salmon use for spawning. Suction dredge mining can also mobilize legacy mercury left by historic mining operations that can then become resuspended in the water column and expose fish and humans to toxic metal contamination. In 2013, the Oregon legislature passed Senate Bill 838, establishing a five-year moratorium on suction-dredge mining in essential salmon and bull trout habitat. Although the limited moratorium provides some level of protection for native fish and water quality, it is only a temporary solution and is scheduled to expire in 2021. The suction-dredge reform bill in front of you is the result of a long and collaborative process. Specifically, the bill prohibits mechanized suction-dredge mining in streams and rivers that provide essential habitat for threatened and endangered indigenous salmon, steelhead, and lamprey. The maps identifying the impacted habitat are created periodically by the Department of State Lands through a public process, and designation employs a rigorous process of observation or concurrence of professional opinion. In affected waterways, which total about 20%, only 20%, of the state streams and rivers, the mining prohibition will extend from the stream bed up to the ordinary high water line. The bill does not include streams that are upstream from natural barriers to fish, like waterfalls and certified human-made dams. Please note that this bill is not a ban on suction-dredge mining. Instead, this compromise legislation strikes a balance between the unique cultural heritage of Oregon mining affirmed in Senate Bill 838 and the significant risks it poses to the health of streams and our native fish. Non-motorized mining, such as gravity dredges and suction dredges, will continue to be allowed in all streams and rivers. Mechanized mining will be allowed in non-regulated streams, about 80% of our total waterways, and in all the riparian areas adjacent to streams. Miners must obtain a permit from the Department of Environmental Quality, which may include specified time, place, and manner conditions articulated in the bill and in the general permit. DEQ can require a payment of a permit fee up to $250 to cover its expenses for administering and enforcing the permit. Violators will be subject to a citation. Colleagues, public policy often requires a balance of competing interests. This bill, the product of many years of discussion, debate, and inevitable work group, forges a pragmatic compromise between the interests of miners who have created a distinct culture and community, and, on the other hand, the iconic salmon and steelhead at the